Managing users in your Matterport account is quite simple. So we're going to take a look at this through the admin view. If you're a user, you don't have admin access, you're not going to be managing different users' access. But I would say pay attention and get an idea of what kind of access can be given. And this will help guide you with your admin if you feel you need to make changes. So here, you'll want to keep kind of an eye on how many users you have to your account limit. So that'll be shown here. And you'll go to your users page in your account here for a little dashboard on your users. In this account, you can see that we've got three current users, myself as an admin, Nate as an admin, and then Alexa as a collaborator. Additionally, I have Pauline, I've invited her to the account, but she hasn't yet accepted it, so she's pending. And I'm going to remind her with a new email on that. Okay, and then here, if I had had any collaborators or users on the account that no longer have access, they'd show up here as deleted. So this is a nice place to see the history of who's had access to the account. If I wanted to invite someone new, simply go here, add an email address, an invitation message if you'd like. You can select if you're inviting them as a collaborator or an admin. And if you've got any doubt about which to do, I would suggest starting with collaborator, and that's easy to change here. And then finally, this is a great feature. You can search for users here. So if you start to get a longer list of users, you get 10, 20 users, real nice and easy way to search for them and see what they've got access to here. Now let's take a look at Alexa's profile and see what she's got access to and make some changes. Here I've got Alexa's basic information. I can see that she's a collaborator. Here, again, I can see that she has collaborator access. I can change that if I'd like. I see here that her upload folder is set at Uploads Alexa. If I wanted to change that, maybe I want to streamline and have her uploads all go to a certain project. So I could change, for instance, to the project Golden Gate here. For now, I'm going to keep her uploads going to the Alexa folder. Okay. And then let's take a look and see what she has access to, what folders and spaces. Okay, so I just clicked on that. We see she does not have access to this individual space. You can tell it's an individual space by this icon here. She has no access to Nate's upload folder. She has editor access to her own upload folder. She can see the Monta Vista project, but she can't edit. Now, maybe I want her to go in and edit and be able to make some changes to that space or to spaces within that folder. So that's a simple click of the button, and now she's an editor. And maybe I don't want her to have access to the Golden Gate project, but I want her to be able to view and at least get in there and see what's in there, but I want to make sure she's not making changes. That's an easy change as well. So you can manage the access at the folder level and again here at the spaces level.